Canada's unemployment rate fell yet again last month to 4.5%. It has been dropping for months and much lower than peak pandemic levels. But the jobless rate is still higher than the pre-pandemic rate, which dipped below 3%. NBC2's Evan Dean explores what needs to happen in 2022 to get people back to work.
Even as our economy recovers, you still see these now hiring signs seemingly all over. And yet there are plenty of people still trying to find jobs.
I've been looking for about 2 months now.
Like Miriam Vieira, who we found at Career Source in Fort Myers. So what gives?
In many ways, I think this is kind of a game changer.
FGCU economist Victor Klar is talking about the pandemic. It's still having an impact on the labor force, maybe always will, because he says those shutdowns changed the American worker, especially those in the service industry.
People are now thinking about work-life balance and staying at home with their kids in ways that they were never given the opportunity to do before.
Klar also pointed to what's called structural unemployment as a concern, a mismatch between the skills needed for available jobs and the skills of available workers.
I'm looking for administration. I used to be a construction coordinator.
And that's the case for Miriam Vieira. She's qualified in her field and doesn't want to settle for something else.
I want to work. Yeah. I want to work, but I am looking for the job that I'm experienced on.
Klar says progress is being made, but a major key to making more may be more flexibility from those hanging those now hiring signs.
Employers now are going to have to think a lot more creatively about the ways that they let their employees have the family work-life balance that's a good fit for them.
Reporting for NBC2, I'm Evan Dean.
And if you're looking for a job, NBC2 can help you with that. We've compiled a list of companies looking to hire on our website. Just go to jobspot.nbc-2.com. You can browse local companies by category to find out what fits you best.